Hi everyone. So in the last session we discussed about the creating the prompts, creating the prompts in the report and how to use that different kind of prompts like optional prompt and mandatory prompts. And also we have discussed about the ranking and the sorting. Okay, in the sorting, so how we can display the data into the different order. So based on the user requirement, so the custom order and the data want to display the descending order, either the ascending order. So that part we have done. And then the ranking, what is the ranking basically? To display the top and top 10 state sales revenue information, or if I want to see the bottom 5 state sales revenue information, to get that particular specific top and bottom values, top and bottom values to display that. So we have to use the ranking option. Okay, so let's continue. So today we are discussing about the breaks and sections and the formulas and variables. So breaks, sections and formulas and variables. So what is the purpose we use the breaks and sections and the formulas and the variables? So that we can discuss. Okay, click on log on to the launchpad. So how to create a report? So select the administration application, select the web intelligence application. Click on new web document, select the universe. See, so we are designing the reports. So till now we discussed about creating a report on a universe only. So but the next sessions, so we can discuss creating a universe on top of the Bex queries also. But as of now we can continue with the creating a report by using the universes only. Okay, so select the universe list, click on OK. So now, so let's select the eFashion universe. So these are the list of the universes you can see, right? So we can create a report by connecting to the universe. So we can create a Webby report by connecting to the Bex queries. Okay? So we can create a report by connecting to the analysis view. These are the different sources by we can connect and we can generate a report. Okay? So here, what is, I'm just creating a universe by connecting to the creating a report by connecting to the universe, right? So let's say, so I'm just selecting the eFashion. So select the eFashion universe. So eFashion universe is a semantic layer and we defined that universe by connecting to the Microsoft Access database. Okay, eFashion is defined by using the Microsoft Access DB. Okay, perfect. So now, so how I'm going to create a report, let's say, so just I'm taking the year object, state I'm taking, and the measure sales revenue quantity sold. Okay, run this query. Now you can see the report in the vertical table format, right? So the universe, like also, it is a semantic layer between the database and the developer, web developer. Okay, so how the universe is, like how the SQL is generated? So based on the universe design, so we need not to know the SQL query as a BO, as a web developer. Okay, but as a universe designer, so you should have some knowledge of the SQL. So why? Because like so you should know like what are the tables are available in the DB. So to know that, so we need to write a simple SQL query in the database side. So for that purpose, we need the SQL knowledge. So SQL knowledge in the sense, so we need to know just SQL select statement. So how to display the, let's say how to display the sales fact information in the database. So let's say select star from sales fact table. Then it will display the all the data which is having the different columns. So everything it will display. So based on that, so we can easily analyze the backend source system. So how the relation between the different tables and how we can design that specific report. So to design that report, how we can design the universe. So all these things, so we can discuss later. So how we can start the universe designing, on what basis we can create a design the universe. So that we can discuss later. Okay. So we are discussing about, as of now, so the functionality of the web report. Okay. So I have selected the state, year and sales revenue and quantity sold and run this query. Now I can see the data into the vertical table format. Now I can see year wise, state wise, sales revenue and quantity sold, right? So 2004. So the 2004, 2005, 2006, 3 years of data is there. So that means, so in the back end, we have the 3 years of data and there are different states. So each state wise, in 2004, each state wise sales revenue which is displaying. Okay. Let's say if I remove this state, what happened? So the data which is going to display the year wise sales revenue. In 2004, what is the total sales revenue? 2006, what is the total sales revenue which is displayed? If I add the state object, so the measures will change. So basically, these are the sales revenue and quantities. All you can see, these are the measure objects and these are the dimension object. Measures are always dynamic based on the dimension objects you added into the block. So those measures will display accordingly. So let's say I'm just adding the state object now. So the values will change, the sales revenue values will change. In 2004, so each state, what is the total sales revenue it is displaying? So in 2004, California, this much of the sales revenue is happened and this much of the quantity sold is happened. Now, my requirement is here, I want to display the total sales revenue. Yes. So yesterday we discussed, so we can display the total sales revenue. That means it's a grand total which is displaying here, right? So grand total, how can see that? So go to the analysis tab and select the sum function. So now you can see the total sales revenue in the footer. Now you can see total sales revenue which is displayed. But user required, so he want to see the, so each year what is the total sales revenue. So I can see the, in a year, each state wise I can see the individual sales revenue. But in 2004, what is the total sales revenue? In 2005, what is the total sales revenue? In 2006, what is the sales revenue? And also I want to see the grand total. Okay, that is what my requirement. And user want to see the subtotals basically. And here, so the values are repeating here, each and every column, each and every row. Why? Because, so in 2004, there are multiple states are there. So that's what it is repeating. So I don't want to repeat these values. So with the break, so I can able to remove these repeated values and I can display the subtotals information by applying the break. Okay. So now what I'm doing, just click here and apply the break. So when you apply the break, now the data which is displaying the year column, year value which is displaying the only one time. And now I want to display the subtotals. So select the sales revenue and apply the summaries. Now you can see the summary information. Let's say add here again. And similarly, you can select this quantity sold and select the sum. Now you can see the data, the each year wise data. You can see in 2004, this is a total sales revenue, and 2005, this is a total sales revenue. Okay. So still I can modify this column. So instead of displaying this 2004 in the first row, if you make it is in the middle, in the center, so it looks nice, right? So what I want to do is basically, so users will give the requirement. So how the users give the requirement? So they want to see the report in this format. They will give the format. So what format they want to see? Let's say, so just simply I will show you here, we have a state and the sales revenue. Okay, they will give the templates in the Excel sheet. Then they are giving the requirements, right? So that time itself, they will give this type of requirement in the Excel sheet. They will prepare Excel they will give it. Or is like whatever they are already using their own reports, which is manually they are creating. So that reports they will share with us, and they will explain with each report what exactly they want to display and what each field it after. So everything they will explain. Okay. So now, so let's say they want to report header, they want to see this some different color. Okay. And so 2004 is here. 2004. Match it, and they want to see the different state wise, different product or city states. So this is the way they will give the requirement. So based on that only, we are going to implement the same report. Okay. But here, what happened? The requirement is like this. So then immediately, so this is a total, and then 2005. And again, there is a state A, C and D. Okay, let's say this is E, and similarly, okay, and similarly, what is this E? Also, you can do it. Sales to win. So for each state wise data which is displaying, right? So now, but my requirement is this, but so whenever I'm applying the break, you can see here. So each year which is displaying data part. Okay, each year which is displaying data part. Yes, we can, how we can display the, change the background color. Yes, we can see that also. Okay, now we can see, so my requirement, the templates is this, the user given the template, this one, but when I apply the break, so the total template is totally, it is different, right? So we can format as per the user requirement. So for that, what I am doing, select here. So we have the break properties. So select here and go to the manage breaks. Now I want to display the values in the center, so just make it as a match. Okay, I don't want to display the break header. Okay, click on OK. Now you can see the data 2004, and now there is a space, there is an empty column. I'm trying to remove this not column, it's a row. I'm trying to remove this row. Remove the row. Okay. Now you can see the data. 2004. Now let's make this. You can match it. This is sum. So instead of the sum, so it is a technical term, make it as a total. Perfect. So total 2004, total sales revenue which is displaying, 2005, each product, each state wise data is displaying, and similarly if you come down, right, so you can see the grand totals. So you can see the grand total here. Okay. So now, but report header is not displaying. So what is this? Is this like a sales revenue? Is it a margin or is it a tax? So I want to display the report header. So how to do that? Simple, to display the report header. So select this table. So I remove the report header in the using the manage breaks. Using the manage break, I will just unselect the break header. Okay. So now I want to display the report header. Again, what we need to do, if you select this manage breaks and report header, right? So each every year it will display the break header. So what I can do, select this table, right click, and select the format table. Now you have the option called the show table headers. Select this show table headers. Now you can see the only the header part. So 2004 total sales revenue for 2004 and 2005. So each state wise, and also you can see the total sales revenue for 2005, and you can see the grand total. Okay, now I can see the data year wise, state wise product information. That's perfect. So as per my requirement. So as user given this requirement, you want to see this kind of report. So that's done. Okay. Now, so I have another requirement. So I want to see each year wise, I want to see into the pie chart wise, I want to display the data. So in 2004, so I want to see the state wise sales revenue, I want to present into the pie chart. So if you take the pie chart here, let's say I'm just taking the pie chart and drop here. Okay. Now I'm taking the state object here. And let's have the sales revenue and drop here. What happened? The sales revenue which is displaying each state wise, right? But here if you see the Texas and the state and New York which is displaying for all the years. But my requirement is here, so I want to see the each year wise, I want to see the pie chart. Okay, in that case, so the break will not work. If you apply the break, so the break option is specific to this block only. So the break is not considering this pie chart, right? Okay. So in that case, so we'll go for other option to display that kind of report. Let's say I'm just taking the same pie block here. Take the year object and drop here. And add a state object. Take the sales revenue. And I have a quantity sold. Okay, fine. So now I want to see the subtotals of the each year, and also I want to see the data in the pie chart. So for that, so here if we want to display the subtotals and displaying the year object only once, I don't want to repeat the year values. In that case, I apply the break. Okay. Same way with other option also, we can display the subtotals as well as we can display the year values only once. I can remove the repeated values. How we can do that? So that we can do it by applying the section. Here you can have a set as a section. If you set as a section, now you can see 2004 data you can see here. And 2005, 2006. The format is different now. Okay. Now I can see the data. So total sales revenue. Go to the analysis tab. Select the summarized information. Now select the sum. Okay. Perfect. So the break. With the break, you can see the year which is displaying the only one time. In the even in the section also. So I have removed the repeated values. I can see the year only the once, right? Then what is the main difference between the break and section? The common thing is I can remove the repeated values and also I can display the subtotals for each year. That is a common. So then what is the difference between the break and section? So let's have a pie chart in the section. Take this pie chart and drop here. So let's have the state object and drop here. Now take the sales revenue and drop here. Now you can see the difference. In the section, let's make it as a section. This is a break report. just modifying the renaming the tabs. This is a brief report. Okay, click on OK. Perfect. Now, in the break, I have added the pie chart. In the section also, after applying the section, I have added the pie chart here. So the difference between the break and section when you add the pie chart, so if you go down, if you scroll down, right, so each 2004, this is about the pie chart. And 2005, you can see the pie chart. 2006, you can see the pie chart, right? In 2004, if you see, so which state is having the highest sales revenue in 2004? So which state is having the highest sales revenue? Maybe Texas. I think the Texas is having the highest sales revenue, right? You can go to the new app. Okay. So 2004 should be only one. So now just so I'm just trying to you understand, guys, what is the difference between the break and section. So in the break, so we cannot apply the multiple blocks. So it is taking as a single block. But if it comes to the section, you can have the multiple blocks in the section. So each year wise, even if you add the one more block, so the particular block it is taking as a section, it is applicable as a section. So in a section, you can have the multiple blocks. In a break, so you cannot have the multiple blocks. Here, if you scroll down this break report, you can see the only the one pie chart. You can see the pie chart. Only the pie chart which is displaying the state-wise sales revenue. If you come to the section, right, the pie chart which is displaying, it is considering as a year object also. If you see here, right, you can see Texas state year is equal to 2004 and the sales revenue is this much. Okay, and each year the sales revenue is different for the different states, right? So the common thing is like most of the all the years the Texas is having the highest sales revenue, but the very less sales revenue is happened here. So maybe in the Colorado is having the very less sales revenue in 2006. In 2005, if you see the Massachusetts is having the very less sales revenue, right? So each year wise state sales revenue which is displaying here. So the main difference between the break and section, in interviews they will ask what is the difference between the break and section. So the common thing is like we can display the subtotals for each year. And also we can remove the repeated values by using the break and section option. But with the break option, I can display the total, grand total information. I can see the grand total. With the section, so you cannot see the grand total. See, so 2004 sales revenue you can see, and similarly 2005. If you go to the end of the page, you don't see the any sub grand total. That is not possible with the section. But still, if you want it, yes, we can display it. So how we can do that? So we can add a one blank cell and we can do the calculations there. That way we can display it. But by default, you don't get that. So that is one thing, is a difference. And in the section, you can add the multiple block. In the break, so we cannot apply the multiple blocks. And another thing is, so with a break option, so let's say suppose I want to see the 2006 data. In that case, we need to scroll down this report. So we need to scroll down to get the 2006 data. But with the section report, so you can go to directly that page. So if you select here, right, in the report map, so if you expand the section, if I select the 2006, so I can go to that particular page, 2006. Okay. In the break, it is not possible. So if you want to see the specific data, you need to scroll down. That navigation, that particular page, you can go it. Okay. Let's say I have the quarter object in the query panel. Okay. Now, so I have added one of the quarter object. Let's say go to the section. Now just add the quarter object and drop here. So whenever, like when, how you can drop it? So if you drop here, right, it will override. So whenever the small rectangle symbol comes, you can drop there. Okay. Okay. Then you can apply the brick. Sorry, you can apply the section here. Let me remove this cell. Okay. Now, so let's select the quarter object and apply a section. So you can apply the section on the multiple columns. Even you can apply the break on the multiple columns. Where is my report? Okay, right click here and set as a section. Now you can see the quarter-wise data, and if you go to the maps, so now you can see, if you expand 2004, and you can see the each quarter-wise data. And let's say if you want to see the 2006 Q3 results, so select the 2006 and select the Q3. Now you can go to the specific Q3 page. Okay, so this is a way we can directly navigate that particular page. So with the break, it is not possible. Okay. So that is the main difference between the break and sections. So now let's move to another concept, how to display the data state wise, and let's say I have the example quarter wise results. Let's have the cross tab report here, drop here. Now take the state object and drop here, and now take the sales revenue. You can see here, so each state, what is the total sales revenue which is displaying, and take the quarter object and drop here. Now you can see each quarter, so what is the total sales revenue in a California. So quarter one, this is the sales revenue, quarter two, this is the sales revenue for, so you can compare the sales revenue for each quarter. Similarly, you can compare the sales revenue for each month. Okay. And let's move to the another concept, which is the formulas and the variables. So I'm creating a one more report. Create a new Webby document. Let's select the, I'm just taking the fashion universe. I'm taking year object, just drag and drop, state and the products, the measures I'm taking, the sales revenue and quantity sold. So run this query. Now my requirement is I want to display the tax on the sales revenue. So how much tax I'm paying for the particular product or in a particular state. Okay, so I want to see the tax, I want to display the tax, 12% of the tax on the sales revenue. So see, that kind of object is not available in our universe. Let's say I'm trying to search here tax, is there is no object as a tax column, tax object. So that we can implement that formulas, we can write it at the report level. Okay, so how to write a formula here? So let's say just I want to display the tax information just right side of the sales revenue. How we can do that? Right click here, insert a new column to the right side. Okay, now here I'm going to write a formula. So let's say example 12%. So how we can do that? So select this column, formula. Click on FX, formula editor. So the sales revenue into 12%, 0.0.12, is it 12%, right? Validate this, formula is correct. No, so that's which is displaying here. Okay, now just here I'm just writing the formula, writing the header tags. Correct. Now let's say I'm inserting another table. I'm inserting another table. So take the state object. So I want to see here in the first report which is displaying the tags and based on the year and the state and product. That means in 2004 in a California state, so I'm paying this much of the tax for the accessories product, right? But I want to see the total tax for California state. How much tax I'm paying in a California state? That is what my requirement. So in that case, so I need to insert a new column and write a formula. Let's say another requirement, add a report. So each product, how much tax I'm paying. That means, so keep on writing the formulas, right? So insert a new column and write a formula. So it is a simple formula. So some formulas will be more, like so multiple columns. So instead of writing a formula, okay, instead of writing a formula, so I can create a variable. So what I'm doing, already written a formula, you can make it as a variable. How to create a variable? So select here, select this object column, and the formula is here. If you select here, right, you can see the formula, right? Now I'm making it as a variable. So just click here, tags. So generally, whenever you are creating a variables, so we always so use the prefix as a V. This is standard we will follow when we create any variable. So any other developer comes, so he can understand that, so this is a variable, so he can easily understand that which are the variable, which are not variable. Here I can see it variables, but if you see again, go back to here and checking that, instead of that, if you maintain this standard V underscore tax, so you other developers can understand easily. Okay, so the sales revenue into 12%. So make it as a measure object. This is a measure object. And click on OK. So V underscore tax is object is created in left hand panel. So we need not to create any formula again. Just you can just drag and drop here. So V underscore tax. So it is going to display the tax, total tax paid in a California state. And similarly, the tax on the each product wise you can see. Let's take the V underscore tax and drop here. Okay. Now we can see the tax on the each product wise. Okay. Now, so I have another formula. I want to create a how much, what is the cost per unit. So I want to see the cost per unit. For each product, what is the cost? So how we can calculate it? So I want to see the cost per unit. So what is the formula for cost per unit? Okay, so I can directly create a variable. How to create a variable? So click on new variable. Instead of just writing a formula and making it as a variable, directly you can create a variable. So click on new variable. Okay, now I want to create the cost per unit. Sales revenue divided by the quantity sold. So I can see the cost per unit. Click on OK. So the cost per unit is the same value for all the products in all the states? No. So each state it will vary, right? So let's say if I take the cost per unit here, so how it will display? So the cost per unit means the accessories cost per unit is $145 in a California state. Maybe if you go to the 2005 or to go to the next page, 2005 year, if you don't see, in the next page you can see. In 2005, what is the cost per unit in California state? You can see it's a $158 in 2005. So it's a $158. And if it is in 2004, the cost is different. It's a 145. It is increased, right? See, similarly, So I can see the average cost per unit. That means, so average cost per unit, you can see, if you take the cost per unit, you can see 153.62. This is the average cost per unit. Okay, but so if you take the year object, the data which is displaying in 2005, 2004, so in 2004 the cost per unit for accessories is $145.26, right? So this is a way, so we can create a variables and formula. So what is a formula? So just it contains the specific, it is a combination of the functions and the objects. So now we have another requirement. Yeah, now we have another requirement. So I want to display the shortcut of the states. I don't want to display the full name. So let's say California is there. I want to see the only the CA. Let's say Colorado is there. I want to see the CO, just CO. If they say New York is there, I want to display the NY. Okay. So how we can do that? So that we can do it again with the variables. Create a variable. So S underscore V underscore short state, or let's just give V underscore state. Now, so we have a different functions here. If you come down here, we have a different functions here. So if you expand all the functions, you can see there are different functions. Count, current date, current time, current user, data provider. So day name and day number of month. So all the functions you can see. If you want to see the each and every function, if you select, let's say, just I'm selecting the lawyer, what it will do? It will convert all the values into the lower cases, right? Let's say just I'm going to, before going to create here, right? Let's say the state. So from the first, the California, first letter it is displaying the caps, right? I don't want to display the caps letter. I want to display the all our lower cases. You can use the function which is a lawyer function. It will display the all the values in the lawyer. Now you can see I have used the function here. Okay, so whenever you are clicking on a one function, so it will display with the syntax. I'm not using my own syntax here. So whatever the syntax of the function, you need to use the same function. You need to maintain the same syntax. Let's say concatenation. What it will do, concatenation? Concatenation is basically this joining the two strings. We can combine the two strings with the concatenation function. So what is the syntax for this? Concatenation of first string and the second string. Let's say I want to see the product lines and state in a single, as a single object. Then you can take the concatenation of state, comma, semicolon, comma lines. Then it will concat the both the state and product lines. Okay. So just I'm showing the example of the each function, how we can see the purpose, what is the purpose of the function, how we can use that function. Okay. Fine. And also, if you want to still, you want to see the detailed information about the function, right? If you click on more function, right? So it will show you with example of that function, how we can use it. Okay. Let's say if you have the help document, I can see that. If not there, let me just take here. It is there. See? So I have selected the concat function, concatenation function. You can see here. Example, concatenation of first and second. So it is this string. So what happened? It will return the first, second, third. Concatenation of first, concatenation of second and third. It is going to display the first, second, third. Right? So this is a way. So it will display the function of the help. If you click on more function, it will display the detailed information about the function. Okay, now, so what is my requirement? I want to display the V underscore short, V underscore state. I want to display the shortcut names for the state. Okay, for that, so let's take the if condition. If state is equals to, if state is equals to California, California, then I want to display the CA. If the condition is true, so whatever you want to display, that you mean you have to mention here. So this is what syntax for if condition. Okay, so then else, just I am writing the state. Okay, what it will display, let me check. You can, okay. So let's have the state v underscore state and drop here. What is this thing? Whenever the if v underscore if state is equal to California, then it is displaying the CA. And remaining else state. So whatever the condition is not true, so then it will display the whatever the values are there. So it will display the same values. Now I want to see the see whenever the California see California is there, I want to see it. And also similarly for other states. So if you want to add a multiple conditions, then you have to use the else if condition. Else if state is equals to, else if state is equals to, then let's say I'm just taking the Colorado. So else if state is equal to Colorado, then I want to display CO. Similarly, you can write a multiple conditions. Just I'm not showing everything. Okay, now you can see, validate this, formula is correct. Perfect. Okay. So what happened? It's not showing. Okay. It's not showing because I've written mistake here. Spelling mistake. Okay, now you can see. So it's going to display the CO. So this is a way you can write a multiple condition. So you can write a formula directly, but I cannot use it another block, right? So to reuse that formula, so we are going to make it as a variable. So always create a variable instead of writing a formula functions. Okay. So then I can reuse this. Like let's say I can reuse this object, this variable in another tab. But I cannot reuse this object in another report. Like in this document, I cannot reuse it. This variable is specific to this document only. Okay. So we can reuse the object means we can reuse that formula. If you create a variable means it is in the within the document only we can reuse that variable. So whenever the state is there, so let's say California, I want to see I want to calculate the 12% of the tax. If it is a DC, so I want to calculate the 9% of the tax. And if it is a Florida, then I want to see the sales, the tax as a 14%. So similarly, so for other states, so other than DC, this is a DC, DA. Yeah, DC only, correct.
DC.
So for other states, so for all the other states, I want to make it as a sales revenue as a 15%. For these three states, I want to see the 12, 9 and 14%. For remaining states, I want to display as a 15%. Okay, we can calculate it. That we can achieve it by writing a variables, by creating variables. So for adding the yesterday's task, so the yesterday task is given. Maybe guys, anybody has tried the yesterday task? Even it is not easy doing this, but you can just do some workaround. You can able to do it if you try it. So not a direct option. Okay. So let's say I'm applying the brake. Okay. So sales revenue. Total sales revenue. Okay. Perfect. So the requirement is here. We already discussed about the sorting order. Sorting, right? So my requirement is I want to see the highest state sales revenue, the first row. So the Texas is having the highest sales revenue, right? So this state I want to display the first row. But what happened when you apply the brake? By default, the data which will display the ascending order, the California and the DC and the Florida, and the last row it is displaying the Texas. But my requirement is I want to display the Texas is having the highest sales revenue, and the next will be New York or the California. New York. So the next row should display the New York, and third row should display the California, and fourth row remaining all the other states it should display. Okay, that is what my requirement. So you can guys try it out by doing the applying the break. Okay.